Hi everyone, this is Tian, and today we're going to read about a tree. Looking at this picture here, can you tell what kind of tree this is? It's an apple tree. Look at this apple here. It's falling from the tree, and the boy is trying to catch it. Let's read more about it. Let's get started. The Giving Tree by Shel, Silverstein. Once there was a tree, and she loved a little boy. And every day the boy would come, and he would gather her leaves, and make them into crowns and play king of the forest. He would climb up her trunk, and swing from her branches, and eat apples. And they would play hide and go seek. Here's a boy, he's hiding behind some rocks. And when he was tired, he would sleep in her shade. And the boy loved the tree very much, and the tree was happy. It looks like the boy carved a heart on the tree, and inside the heart, there's the word me, which stands for the boy, and there's the letter T, which stands for the tree. But time went by, and the boy grew older. This time, it looks like the boy is hanging out with someone new, and on the tree, the boy carved another heart, but this time, instead of the letter T, it is replaced with the letter Y and L. I wonder who that stands for. And the tree was often alone. Then one day the boy came to the tree, and the tree said, "Come, boy, come and climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and eat apples and play in my shade and be happy." "I am too big to climb and play," said the boy. "I want to buy things and have fun. I want some money. Can you give me some money?" "I'm sorry," said the tree, "but I have no money. I have only leaves and apples. Take my apples, boy, and sell them in the city. Then you will have money, and you will be happy." Do you think the boy will be happy after he gets some money? And so the boy climbed up the tree and gathered her apples and carried them away. And the tree was happy. But the boy stayed away for a long time, and the tree was sad. And then one day the boy came back, and the tree shook with joy, and she said, "Come, boy, climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy." "I am too busy to climb trees," said the boy. "I want a house to keep me warm," he said. "I want a wife, and I want children, and so I need a house. Can you give me a house?"
"I have no house," said the tree. "The forest is my house, but you may cut off my branches and build a house, then you will be happy."
Do you think the boy will be happy after he gets a house?
And so the boy cut off her branches and carried them away to build his house. And the tree was happy.
Look at the tree now. She has lost her branches and her apples. How do you think she's still happy?
But the boy stayed away for a long time, and when he came back, the tree was so happy she could hardly speak.
"Come, boy," she whispered. "Come and play."
"I am too old and sad to play," said the boy. "I want a boat that will take me far away from here. Can you give me a boat?"
"Cut down my trunk and make a boat," said the tree. "Then you can sail away and be happy."
Do you think the boy will be happy this time after he gets a boat? And so the boy cut down her trunk and made a boat and sailed away. And the tree was happy, but not really. There's almost nothing left of the tree. And after a long time, the boy came back again.
"I am sorry, boy," said the tree, "but I have nothing left to give you. My apples are gone."
"My teeth are too weak for apples," said the boy.
"My branches are gone," said the tree. "You cannot swing on them."
"I am too old to swing on branches," said the boy.
"My trunk is gone," said the tree. "You cannot climb."
"I am too tired to climb," said the boy.
"I am sorry," sighed the tree. "I wish that I could give you something, but I have nothing left. I am just an old stump. I am sorry."
"I don't need very much now," said the boy. "Just a quiet place to sit and rest. I am very tired."
"Well," said the tree, straightening herself up as much as she could. "Well, an oat stump is good for sitting and resting. Come, boy, sit down. Sit down and rest." And the boy did. And the tree was happy. The end.
If you were the tree, would you be able to give so much to the boy and still be happy? Why do you think this tree is still happy after giving so much to the boy? Alright, that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!